This is the booklouse. Most likely one of the most common synanthropic psocid species, Dorypteryx domestica. The details of its coloration with pinkish spots on the back are clearly visible, but only in the video at close-up. In reality, in the house, you will see it like this. Here is the windowsill, the light-colored wall, and if you don't look closely, you might not even notice the insect here. And to look at it again, get closer, and here the little booklouse appears again. It is so small that not every person can see it. You need to have good eyesight to see all the details of its morphology. Its size is about 1 millimeter, including these legs and spots on the body. And this is true for all booklice that live in houses. They are all small, all of them are 1 to 1.5 or 2 millimeters in size. The largest of such widespread psocids is the larger pale booklouse. It reached a length of 1.5 to 2 millimeters. The other species are smaller. Here, for example, is another indicative video. The same Dorypteryx species on the tiles in the bathroom. You can compare its size with the width of the seam between the tiles. And here the finger appears next to it, and it shows us too how small this psocid is. Did you notice, yeah, that the booklouse jumped away a few centimeters from the finger? This is a distinctive feature of these insects. Even if you can't see the details of the coloration and can't count the legs of this creature because of its small size, then such a jumping ability test will definitely help you distinguish the booklice from the gamasid mites. These mites are about the same size, but do not jump. By the way, you can watch a collection of videos with booklice that my viewers sent me last year. And if after that you still can't recognize your insects, then send me videos of them and I will try to identify them for you.